The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 8th chapter, text number 20 through 22, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in October of 1966 in New York.
Parastasmatu bhavanya bhaktyavakta sanatana yasas sarveshu bhuteshu na sasu na vinasati. This verse we have been discussing from the last day. There is another nature. Parastasmatu bhava. Bhava means nature. And para. Para means superior. So there is another superior nature. Bhakta abhakta sanatana. Bhakta means what you see manifested. Now this material universe you are seeing manifested, practically not seeing, but at least at night we can see how the stars are twinkling, so many planets, innumerable. This is manifested. And beyond that manifestation there is covering of the universe. Bhakta abhakta. And beyond that abhakta, there is another material nature, spiritual nature. So Krishna is pointing out that nature, parastasmatu bhava anya bhaktavakta sanatana. Sanatana means eternal. This nature, this material nature, it has got its beginning and end. But that spiritual nature, that has no beginning and no end. How it is? You can understand by a simple example. Just like this sky, and in some insignificant part of the sky, there is some cloud. And the cloud covers us. When there is cloud or snowfall, we see everything is covered. But that covering is only an insignificant part of the whole sky. That covering is not for the whole sky. Because we are very minute, small, so a few hundred miles if it is covered, the sky, we see that everything is covered. Similarly, this material sky is within the covering, with the covering of mahatattva, matter. And as the cloud, when it is clear, the original sky you can see, similarly, this covering of material matter, when it begins, so the cloud has beginning and end, similarly, this material nature has beginning and end. Just like your body, it has got its beginning and end, simply for some time. We get our birth of this body, we stay for some time, it grows, it gives some byproducts, then it dwindles, then vanishes. This six transformation. So similarly, anything material, manifestation that you are seeing, observing, that is under these six kinds of transformation. So at the end, it will be vanquished. So Krishna says, parastasmattu bhava anya bhaktyavakta sanatana. Beyond this vanquishing cloud-like material nature, there is another superior nature, which is sanatana, eternal. It has no beginning, no end. And jasa sarveshu bhuteshu na sasu na vinasati. When this material manifestation will be annihilated, that will remain. Just like the cloud, when it is vanquished, when it is annihilated, the sky remains. Similarly, spiritual sky will remain. The material covering of the spiritual sky will be vanquished. This is called ghatakas patakas. So, there are many volumes of knowledge of this material sky and spiritual sky. In Srimad Bhagavatam, second canto, you'll find description of the spiritual sky, what nature it is, what kind of people remain there, what is their future, everything. Even we get information that in spiritual sky there is aeroplane. Spiritual aeroplane in the spiritual sky. And the living entities, they are liberated, they travel on the spiritual sky on that plane, and it is so nice, just like lightning, the description is. They travel just like lightning. So everything is there. This is only imitation. This material sky and everything, whatever you see, all imitation. Shadow. It is shadow. Just like in cinematographic picture, you see the shadow of the real thing behind. Similarly, this is only shadow. And in Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said that janmādasya jataha annayāt itaratascha artheshu avijñasarāt yatra tisagga amrisha. This material world is a combination of matter. Just like you have seen a nice girl's doll in the showcase of the shopkeepers. Exactly, just like a nice, beautiful girl. But that is imitation. Imitation. Every sane man knows that this is imitation. So whatever we are seeing here, beautiful, they are all imitation of the real, as the doll is imitation of a beautiful girl. Similarly, jasya sattataya mithyapi sattameva abhipadyate. Siddhar Swami says, because the spiritual world is real and this unreal manifestation appears to be real, but it is not real. We can understand. Reality will exist. Reality will not vanquish. That reality means eternal. Therefore, real pleasure, that is Krishna. The material pleasure is temporary, not actual. Therefore, those who are after reality, they don't take part in this shadow pleasure. Shadow pleasure, they don't take part. So, Lord Krishna says, jasa sarveshu bhuteshu na sasu na vinasyati. That is reality. When everything will be vanquished, that spiritual nature will continue to remain. That remains always. So, our aim is, the human life's aim is to reach that spiritual sky. But they do not know. Bhagavad says, nati vidu. They do not know that there is reality. There is reality. Nate vidu sartha gatengi Vishnu. They do not know their self-interest, that this human life is meant for understanding that reality and prepare for being transferred into that real reality, not to remain. The whole Vedic literature instructs like that. Tamasi ma jyoti gama. Don't remain in this darkness. This material world is darkness. We are artificially making it illuminated, electric light and fire and so many things. But the nature is dark. But that nature, that spiritual nature, is not dark. That is full of light. Just like the sun planet, there is no possibility of darkness. Similarly, every planet there, they are self-illuminated. So there is no darkness. This description we will get from Bhagavad Gita. Natatra bhāsayate sujya nasasānka napāvaka jadgatyāna nivattante tadhyāmam paramam mama Lord Krishna says, oh, that spiritual sky, there is no need of sun, there is no need of moon, there is no need of electricity. Natatra bhasayate surya, surya means sun. Na sasanka, neither moon, na pavaka, pavaka means fire, electricity. These things are not required there. That is my abode. Anyone who goes there, he doesn't come back again. We get eternal life. So, Krishna says, abhakta akshara ittuktam samahu paramangatim. That non-manifested, because in the material eyes, material science, it is not possible to disclose by material science. We material, what is material science? We cannot go into the moon planet. What to speak of the spiritual planet? It is not possible. It is not possible. So, abhaktakshuttakta paramangasim, that is the, if we want to penetrate the outer space, we should be able to penetrate this outer space and discover it, then enter into that spiritual sky, and there it is called paramangati. That sort of journey is called supreme. Not that you go 25,000 away from this planet and again come back. This is not very heroic. You should have to penetrate the whole material space and then penetrate the cover and then reach the real star. Yes. And that information is here in the Bhagavad Gita. Paramangati. That is the superior journey. That you cannot do with your teeny Sputniks. It is not possible. That you have to do by Krishna consciousness. Sadatadabhava-bhavitam. One who always absorbed in Krishna consciousness, and if by fortune at the time of death he thinks of Krishna, he is at once transformed within a second. That is the process. Therefore, if we at all want to go that spiritual sky and attain real life, eternal life, blissful life, and full of knowledge, Sachidananda Vigraha. Ishara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha. The Lord has got this body, Sachidananda Vigraha. We have also that sort of body. But it is very small. And now it is covered by this matter, by this dress. And if we somehow or other able to give up this false dress, then we reach that spiritual kingdom, God's kingdom, that is paramangati. Jang prapa, if you can reach there, if you can achieve that perfection, jang prapya, na nivartante. At once you go, you cannot, no more to come back. Jang prapa na nivartante ta dhamma paramangamo. That is my superior abode. So everyone should try to go there. God Himself comes to call you. He sends His Son to call you. And the literatures are there. The scriptures are there. We should take advantage of this. This is meant for human body, human life, not for the cats and dogs. So we should take advantage of this. Human life is meant for that achievement. Then we finish all this trouble. This trouble of repeating birth and death, the cycle of birth and death, this should be stopped. This is the information of Bhagavad Gita. This is the perfection. any system, either yoga system or jnana system or bhakti system, anything, if you, whatever you like, you can accept. But the ultimate goal is this paramangati. If this is not achieved, then all yoga exercise and all philosophical speculation are nonsense. Simply waste of time. Simply a waste of time. Aradhita jadi haris tapasa tatat kim. If you can achieve this stage, then there is no other necessity of philosophizing or yogic practice or anything. If you receive that, if you reach that perfection. And if you do not reach that perfection, then it is all useless. The aradhita jadi haris tapasa tatat kim. Naradhita jadi haris tapasa tatat kim. One who reaches there, for him, all kinds of penances, austerities, no more required. And one who does not reach that place, all these austerities, penances, useless, simply waste of time. So, this should be the aim of human life. Human civilization, human society should be so firm that they should have the opportunity. This human form of life is the opportunity to get this boon. So it is the duty of the state, duty of the parents, duty of the guardians, duty of the husband, duty of the father. Everyone's duty is how to elevate a living creature who has got this fortunate human form of life to understand these paramangati, highest perfection of life. That should be the mode of thought. Simply have some eating and sleeping and mating and some defense and quarreling like cats and dogs. This is not civilization. The human civilization is this, that he so properly utilize this human form of life and take advantage of this knowledge and prepare himself in Krishna consciousness so that always 24 hours, 100% he will be absorbed in Krishna. And at the time of death, at once transformed. This should be the process of life. Therefore, we are taking this movement, Krishna consciousness. Join us, cooperate with us. Yourself will be benefited, and the world will be benefited. This Krishna consciousness. Jang prapana nivartante tad dhamo paramangamo. The Lord says, that superior place, superior nature, if somebody can go there, then he has no more to come back here. He gets the highest perfection of love. Now, what is the nature and what are the paraphernalia? Now, here it is said, purusasya parapratha bhaktya labhastamannaya. Now, if we are at all interested to reach that supreme abode, then the process is bhakti. Bhaktya. Bhaktya means devotion and service. Submission. Submission to the supreme law. Bhaktya means bhaja. It is Sanskrit word. The root meaning is bhajadhatutti. Bhaj. Bhaj means service. The bhajdhatukti bhakti, the bhaktya. Here it is clearly said, purusasya parapratha bhaktya labhya sananaya. Sananaya means without any other engagement. Bhakti means the definition of bhakti, devotional service, is given in authoritative books like Narada Pancharatra. It is said there that this is the definition of bhakti. Sarvapadivininmuktam tatvartena nirmalam. So now we are encumbered with so many designations. Designation. This body is Indian, it is a designation. Your body American, it is a designation. You are not this body, not this designation. Suppose you got university gives you a degree, MA or BA, PhD. That degree you are not. It is a designation. So, bhakti means you have to get yourself from this designation. Sarva upadhi. Upadhi means designation. sir, somebody gives me title, Sir Hamilton, or this, or that. Oh, I become very happy. Oh, I've got this Sir title. But I forget that this is my designation. It will exist so long I've got this body. But the body is here to vanquish. So designation will vanquish. When you get another body, then you get another designation. Suppose in this body I'm American, and next body is at China, then you become Chinese designation. So we are changing our designation. We should stop this business, sub-designation. You see? The Sarvabhadi being, if one is determined to get out of all this nonsense designation, then he can attain bhakti. So Sarvabhadi Vininmuktam Tatparatena Nirmalam. Nirmalam means complete pure. What is that purity? Oh, I am spirit, aham brahmasmi, aham brahma. I am Brahma, I am not this matter. This is my covering. And I am eternal servant of Krishna. That is my real identity. So, one who is freed from the designation and is situated in his real constitutional position, that person, when he is fixed up, when he renders service in that Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam, Bhakti Richard, Rishikena, Rishik means the senses. Now my senses are designated. When my senses will be free from designation, and with that freedom, in that purity, when I shall engage in Krishna consciousness service, that is called devotional service. So, Sarvapadi Vininmuktam Tatparatena Nirmalam, Rishikena Rishikesa Sevalam Bhakti Richard. This is explained by Rupa Goswami. He says, Annavilasita sunnam jnanakarmad anabritam anukullena krishnanu silalam bhakti ruchyat. Anukullena, favorable. We have to serve Krishna favorably, not unfavorably. Annavilasita sunnam. We want to serve God with some material purpose, some material gain. Of course, that is also nice. If somebody goes to God for some material gain, he is far better than the person who never goes to God. That is admitted in the Bhagavad Gita. Satyudhida bhajante maam sukhitina arjuna artho arthati. That is a better man. But we should not be. We should not go to God with some purpose of material benefit. We should be free from this. Annavilasita sunnam and jnana karma anabritam. Jnana karma. Karma means work with some fruitive result. I am working in Krishna consciousness just to get some profit out of it. No, this should not be. And jnana means I am trying to understand Krishna. Of course, we shall try to understand Krishna. But God or Krishna is so unlimited, we cannot actually understand. We cannot understand. It is not possible for us. Therefore, we have to accept whatever we can understand. That's why this Bhagavad Gita is presented for our understanding. We should so far understand. The jnana karma anabritam anukullena krishna anusilanam. Culture of Krishna favorably. Like Krishna, how is Krishna is pleased, we should do like that. We should know how Krishna is pleased, how we can know. This Bhagavad Gita is there. And take the right interpretation from a right person, then you'll know what Krishna wants. And do accordingly. Anukullena Krishna anusilanam bhakti ruttama. Then you are elevated to the first class, a devotional service. You see? First class devotional service. Everything should be anukul. Anukul means favor. So these things are there. It is a great science, and we have got immense literature for this. If we have got time, we can utilize, we can understand this science and prepare ourselves for the supreme benefit. the Purusha. So in that spiritual planet, Purusha Sapara Pratha, there is the Supreme Personality of God. In the spiritual planet, there are just like you see here millions of planets or stars within this universe. This universe is a small particle only. There are many universes like this. And in the spiritual sky, there are this is only 1/4 manifestation of the planets. There are other 3/4 is there in the spiritual sky. That information is there in the Bhagavad Gita. So each and every spiritual planet, there is expansion of Krishna, and they are differently named. In that picture we'll find how the Bhagavad. In your Bhagavad. So Purusha. They are all Purusha. Purusha means the person. They are not impersonal. Purusha. Purusha sapara, but superior. Purusha sapara pratha. Bhaktyalabhya. You can approach that Purusha simply by devotional service, not by challenge, not by philosophical speculation, or not by exercise of this yoga and that yoga. No. Simply by surrender and devotional service. It is clearly stated. It is not stated that you can reach there by philosophical speculation or mental concoction or by some physical exercise. This is not possible. You have to reach there bhaktya, by devotion, ananaya, ananacheta, without deviation to this karma fruitive activities or the philosophical speculation or this exercise. No, simply this devotional service, unalloyed devotional service, without any mixture. If you can adopt that, then, and how is that Purusha? Jasya antasthani bhutani jena sarvam idam tatam. He is such a Purusha, he is such a person, that everything, whatever you see, is within him, and he is without all pervading. He has got such energy. How it is that? Just like the sun is fixed up in one place, located, but the sun rays is all over the universe, is distributed. Similarly, although God is there, still His energy is distributed everywhere. And He is not different from His energy. Just like the sun shine and the sun is not different. The same illuminating substance. Similarly, He is distributed all over by His energies, different energies. And He is not different from His energy. Just like if there is electric energy, you can light up any lamp from anywhere. Similarly, if we are progress, if we are advanced in devotional service, we can see God everywhere, anywhere. We require to be qualified. Premanjana charita bhakti vilochanena santat sadaiva hridaye subhilokandi. Those who have developed that love of God, they are constantly 24 hours seeing God before Him. Santa sadaiva. Sadaiva means 24 hours, constantly. Not that, I have seen God yesterday night, now He is not. No. He is always visible. And God is everywhere. You can see Krishna everywhere. But we have to develop that eyes. So these are the process of Krishna consciousness. We should invite you to come and cooperate with us. This is a great science, and let us take advantage of it. Thank you very much.